干的眼球。
我的妹，哪有过你那么烦？我们也 ，with this leaders of the working committee, national executive committee, who are ready to introduce the challenge to you. Museveni had just lifted a ban on multi-party democracy, just as a cover for him to push for the removal of presidential term limits from our constitution. He also wanted the party to be done, so he can expel those who don't agree with him from his party. The fact that the democratic chain emerged out of these events as a rescue platform. The 1995 constitution that introduced a 5-year term for president would not have allowed Museveni to contest the 2006 election. But in his view of fair, prudent ways, Mr. Museveni pretended that he was pushing for the lifting of ban on political parties. Imagine a ban he had himself imposed. And as usual, there are people who are. This background is very important because half of Uganda's population has been born after these events. They don't even remember that they happened. The 2002 population and housing census put the total population of Uganda at 24.4 million. We are now about 45 million people. This means half of the population has been born after the formation and the registration of the FDC. Before I take leave of this program, I invite every FDC leader, those who are here and those who are not here, to ponder this demographic configuration and its effect on the party. It would seem easy to back the FDC to the population of 2004 at its formation because of the prevailing circumstances in the country at that time. Marketing it in this new technological era where the phone that you carry has become the main source of information requires a lot of ingenuity. There is therefore a real danger of this current party stagnating and eventually becoming irrelevant in people's mind if we do not change course. Mind you, there are other political parties in the market for people to choose from. We are not the only political party that seeks to carry and lead this country. We have the duty therefore to erode ourselves to appear attractive to half of the country's population that has been born since the registration of the FDC. We also have a duty to cause the return of every member who has left the FDC. People are struggling. You cannot share your door and say so and just don't come back and do this. Everybody must welcome. We must also make everybody a leader and a member of the FDC comfortable that you and I are keeping the right company. We have a duty. In time of elections, headed political parties renew themselves. Yesterday, you see selects, those of you who are sitting there, shed off all the skin and you can embrace a new one. That's how we do that in the UK. That's what in time we have to ask everybody to achieve. To begin meeting again, who? Unfortunately, our internal election is a huge opportunity to position ourselves once again as being selfishly abandoned. The party president, Engineer Martin Kamayan, told us in all of the recent National Selective Committee meetings that we are heading for a state. You can ask the members who are here. It is this observation that made us think twice about rush in this election. And we say a solution must be found before we plan to do this election, whether you are forewarned not by anyone else but the president. That's why the National Executive Committee at its 239th meeting on June 16th voted to stay elections for at least 1 month to try to resolve the underlying issues that may cause the spill. The Executive Committee made the following resolution. During this 1 month, the Committee of Elders, headed by Dr. Frank Lawiso, investigated the suspicious money that came into FDC during the 2021 election, concluded that investigation and imposed national council. That was the resolution of the National Executive Committee. The National Executive Committee also resolved that we will need to have an emergency national council, among other things, to receive and also discuss this report on the suspicious money. We also resolved that we will convene a meeting from the National Executive Committee to try to reconcile ourselves and speak about candidates in the future of this party. We further recommended that other forums, including the parliamentary caucus, which I had, should meet the party leadership and we encourage other meetings so we can put our house in order before we go for election. These four activities were supposed to be undertaken before the resumption of the electoral process. Only the parliamentary caucus has yet a part of the party leadership. And that meeting came to close to show. In fact, the meeting proposed to finalize the other thing had not happened. And then I hear so many elections there. Elections. Yes, elections are true, but they must be foundation. They are not a ceremony. Let me now deal very briefly with the suspicious fact because that investigation is ongoing. Mosaic Katende was part of the committee investigating. This money came into the party during the general elections of 2021. The EU amount and source is now a subject of investigation by the Elders Committee. Because this money did not come into the party the usual way, it has become very difficult to account for it. I have been a leader of the FDC. I sit in all organs for the last 8 years. We didn't have a finance committee. When money comes into the party, we see, receive it and keep the confidence of those who have given it to us and then assign it the responsibility. This particular one, I have never such a meeting to receive it or even know where it came from. It was brought by the Secretary General, the Pastor President was one of the cities. The President told us in a meeting that the amount he had received and kept at his home, he later passed it on to the party, I don't know which party. The purchases of brand new vehicles from Uber Motors at Nakawa and sudden construction by the cities that coincided with the arrival of the money suggest it was in millions. This was carried away in the middle of an election. And you know, I was at the center, putting very deep into one nominee. I am the one who drove the party president. I say this thing not because I don't like him, but we must choose to ourselves. We cannot pretend forever. The President and Secretary General, together with their president,
why you can't get a shoe. The real self is now saying we'll go to sleep. I think we don't know what the real mission is. He said, we are headed for sleep when we go for an election. And then the other day, he was saying, election must take place. People are saying, no, let's ask the house to go there. No, no, you are there in that. I think the real plan is to fight so hard to push anyone who speaks about to find out of the FDC. Remember in 7204 Ephraim campaign to the Yehovah. Let us see the video of them. That was the story of the campaign message. Let me speak about the state of election. Some of us involved in the year vow fights with the looters who are looting our country. And now being made to be free to put our house on fire. Yet more than before, the struggle to remove is more just fine. His family, his family, has taken over our country. They are now robbing us in the road in there. And I am saying this is never going to take people to attend you. They are more dangerous than those who are robbing mobile religious. Genocide is here. Museveni's young brother has installed himself as a co-president, feeling in the gaps for his ego and sometimes his brother. Genocide took over National Commercial Advisory Services, NADS, which has an annual budget of 500 million shillings that he wanted to make the employment and wealth. That was his vision. More than 2 million shillings perished in this 2 years operation with the population. When the veteran lost the money and did not become wealthy, his brother said, now we're younger. Then they started another studio and went to do this. Then they said, now we are actually wrong with the model. I hope you guys know how much money we spent on the seven and his wife per day. We told you this when we are handling the budget. Every day we spent 1.1 million on the seven and his wife because they are children have grown and left the same house. We are spending on the seven, 47.7 million per hour. We are spending 800,000 on seven and his wife per minute. Let me put it out here. Every two seconds. Every 2 minutes. We are spending 1.5 million on seven. Every 2 minutes. I count how many minutes you have been here. Sometimes you can survive every problem is giving them all this money. You begin imagining your grandmother who is sick. And guys, every 2 minutes, they are 1.5 million. I hope you know that Sahara has put an industrial park in America using your taxes. Where do you think he gets the money he dishes out every day? That is anything to be said. You see, the number of people in Uganda, you see the number of people in Uganda doesn't have a salary. Mr. Benny's son, the son in the officer, in total violation of the constitution, and the PDF Act, is involved in partisan politics, for which I came to the Kedero to Mbuni, where I arrested and detained. These days, Mr. Benny's son is the campaign master. For those who are defending, you have seen some of these from home. And then people pass his budget and he says, I want to go and buy hospitals and the destination is both by the government. And you think you are the man. You are going to pass the budget. After passing the budget, you are on your way to and need to both by the government because you want to develop your hospitals. But let's see where we are as a country. Museveni's wife is in charge of what I gave this sector. Which all of you know is riddled with high levels of dropout. Yet she has access to an budget of over 2 years. She, Museveni's sister, Juliet Kabili, is first chairperson of one of the public service and Education Service Commission. The husband, Museveni's Muko, a chairman, has taken over Uganda's printing and publishing operation.
The result of setup and nepotism is deteriorating quality education, deteriorating healthcare, and breakdown of major infrastructure like the roads. Fighting these perils is what should occupy us and what is for when we can be our leader. That's what we are going to do. Let me now speak about what is in our area. But in a way, internal elections are good for fostering democracy. But holding them must not be a ceremony, but it's a judge in the election. Every political election must be preceded by registration, cooperation, and voters in register. Every member of the new must be facilitated to register and take part in an election. Even seven who steals election does this. You know, your exercise for the voters in Israel, you guys in Israel, the voters in Israel will be displayed. Well, for this, you really know how many people are able to vote in Uganda. After that exercise, you will proceed to steal election. Those who want to steal election, where do you run from seven? There are things you do before you steal. You don't start by stealing. You start by doing these things, then you can proceed and steal election. This is common sense. After that, I have said after voters in Israel, issuance of voters card, everybody now thinks the examination will all go and you get it by yourself. But when you have no that's going to be. You have made the latest data of you from our Secretary General, you are going to have a file. Dated 6 July 2023. Title. Registration and update in members in Israel. This letter says, let me read for you part of that letter. The registration of members is an exercise that has been ongoing since 2015 with group books that were provided to the lady. Kindly update these registers early today because therefore, during this period of the structural map, we are providing registration books and sheets to extract the village membership that will be used by the Electoral Commission to conduct structures in the respective districts. Each sub-region will be provided. Uganda Yanchar.